So hi, here's Michael Yander. I'm currently in a place called the Cavendish Hotel. It's in London in the United Kingdom. And as you read, probably here or somewhere else, I'm traveling around to talk to some of the absolutely most knowledgeable people in the email marketing and marketing automation space. And today I got lucky because I invited one of these people here to have a talk with me and you now, and her name is Mia. She's originally from South Africa, and she works for a company called Striata, and I've asked her here to ask her some questions that I think you will find interesting when you hear her answers.
Hi, Michael.
So first, would you tell us who you are and what your background is?
Well, my name is Mia Papanicolaou, and I've been in email marketing for the last 10 years, focused primarily on email marketing, and over the last year I've been focused on transactional and transpromo marketing when it comes to sending out bills, which is what the company I work for, Striata, specializes in, sending out encrypted, secured documents via email.
And Striata is from where?
Striata started out in South Africa and had a unique selling point in that it sends out statements that are encrypted via email. And it was such a unique selling point. It wasn't available worldwide. And so it started expanding about 7 years ago into the United States, Asia, and Europe.
Ah, I see. And you're now here in the United Kingdom?
Yes.
Okay. And you have a bit of email marketing background, right?
I do.
Yeah?
I do.
Yeah?
Quite a lot of email marketing background, which is quite good when it comes to actually consulting in this very different world of billing on how it works on email, you know, what works and what doesn't, bringing a different side, which companies haven't considered when they're sending out a statement via email.
Ah, interesting. So you talked earlier to me about missing opportunities. So what are the messaging opportunities that that marketers have forgotten?
Well, there's such a large array of messages that get sent to a customer, and marketers are in control of a really small portion of those. And the messages that are being sent to customers vary from your statement, as I mentioned before, to a welcome that gets triggered off a website, or if you're doing something on a website and an email is triggered, that usually comes through in text. And marketers aren't necessarily in control or involved in those messages. Those are missed opportunities for marketers. Is the branding on those messages? Are the marketing opportunities on those messages, have they taken the right steps to get the right message to the right customer, applying the same rules they do in email marketing to these transactional messages? There's so many of them, they just need to start one at a time and start getting through all the gambit of communications that go through to a customer.
So what could, let's say a marketer actually got involved in that side of the business, which I suppose most of the time is organized by whoever is responsible for billing, right?
Yes, they're usually organized by different departments within the company, which is why marketers haven't traditionally been involved. And so they'll have to start working with departments they haven't traditionally worked with, billing being one of them, and start looking at a statement, how it's laid out, is it easy to read, looking at layout and looking at the opportunities that they would in a normal email marketing and applying it to transactional messages. It's really, really important because it's currently not being done at all. So there's a massive opportunity for marketers to get involved and get the brand, a strong brand, across to the customers.
But if we look, you know, apart from the brand message, what are the upsides here? Could you mention some tangible upsides? If let's say a bank, for example, paid more attention to their transactional messages?
Well, there are so many opportunities, and those opportunities are around cross-selling and upselling. And we've seen quite a few companies now adding cross-selling and upselling messages to transactional emails, drop baskets, receipts. But there's so many other communications that haven't actually taken care of. And so they should start, when you're sending out a statement and it's specifically around a certain product, start cross-selling and upselling around that product. Make the marketing relevant to the transactional message that's being sent out. There are opportunities, and it's not just about applying a banner to those emails that are being sent out. It's applying relevant messaging to those emails to make sure that the customers actually purchase.
So you're talking about differentiation and customization, are you?
Absolutely. Applying the same rules that anyone would apply in email marketing and applying them to these transactional messages. Don't forget the messages and don't just apply a banner. put some interesting and clever ideas into these messages. Look at the customization, look at the profiling, and add messages that are meaningful to each customer.
And Striata, over the years, I'm assuming now, please verify, that Striata have seen some great results for your clients?
We've seen fantastic results for clients. These are messages that customers expect to receive. When they sign up to receive an email bill, for example, they expect to receive it every month, and trust me, they open it because it's about the money that is either being taken out of their account or they need to pay. So when you have a customer that's expecting a message and is opening the message, this is the perfect platform to add marketing, and the results are fantastic.
You know, it sounds really, I wish I owned a bank or something, because I'd start doing that right away. It makes a lot of sense. So Mia, the last question I have for you is an easy one. If people wanted to get in touch with you, how would they go about that?
Well, they can either find me on Twitter, which is Mia Papanicolaou. I know it's a really, really
that was easy.
long surname. Yeah. On LinkedIn, LinkedIn/Mia Papanicolaou, or on my email, mia.papanicolaou@striata.com.
Thanks a lot. We'll also post it here somewhere on this page if you're looking at this page, at this video on our page. Thanks a lot, Mia.
Thank you very much, Michael.